Hi guys, so for a bit of extra fun, I wanted to show you how to deploy a bit more of a complex stack using AWS CloudFormation. Now this webpage, and the link will be in the course, and basically this webpage gives you a whole load of different templates which you can use. And they're organized by these various services. So if we scroll down, we've got auto-scaling, AWS batch, config, DynamoDB, EC2, and so on. So there's quite a lot here. And what we're going to do is we're going to launch this particular template here. So what you can do is you can actually click on launch stack straight from this web page. Now I've also included the code here so you can have a look at it. So it's in your code and files directory under CloudFormation. So you can see this is a much more complex template because there's quite a lot going on here. So we've got various things. We've got a subnets being defined, instance types, the key pair name that we're going to use, the SSH location, and so on. And then there's mappings. Remember I mentioned to you them before. So this is able to map information specific to a region. We've got the same for the AWS instance type, and then the actual AMI IDs as well for each region. And then we've got our resources. So our web server group, we've got our launch config, we've got our application load balancer down here, the listener and the target group for the load balancer, and so on, as well as security groups and so on. And then there's output. So an output will actually give us the URL of the website that's going to be created. So there's quite a lot going on there, and it's certainly not part of this course to obviously teach you all of that in detail. But hopefully it gives you a taster of, you know, what you can do with CloudFormation. Back in CloudFormation, so we're in Oregon, and we've loaded that template. And one of the things that we need to do, so if you remember back in the template, it mentions a key name up here. So we do need to have a key pair, and it's actually going to ask us for it as part of the wizard when we try and launch our stack. And you'll notice also that I'm in Oregon this time. So the template has brought me to Oregon. And what I'm going to do is open up the EC2 management console, and I'm going to check and see if I have a key pair in this region. Now we haven't used this region before, so what I'm going to do is just create a key pair. I'm going to call this one Oregon-KP, and I'm going to keep it as a PEM file and click on create key pair. Let's click on allow, and that's going to download my key pair. So now that I have that, I can go back and launch my stack. Let's click on next. I'll leave the default name. So here we get to choose the key pair. So you see it already knows that I need to specify a key pair here. I can keep the instance type as T2 small or change it to a T2 micro if I want to. Let's change it to T2 micro in this instance. Make sure that we're in the free tier. I'll leave SSH location. For subnets, you can add, you know, however many subnets you want here. So let's just add a few subnets. Configure our VPC ID, click on next, scroll down, click on next again, and we can accept most of the defaults and then just choose to create our stack. So really quite simple, even though there's such a lot of complexity. Really the complexity is in the code in writing those templates. So it's great when we've got some from AWS that we can use. Now this will take a few minutes. And what I suggest you do is watch here and see what's happening. You can keep clicking refresh, but also head over to the EC2 management console and see what's going on. So in here, we should see that we've got some information being created. So we should have some resources being created. So under target groups, I can see that I have a target group being created. Let's check if there's a load balancer yet. And yes, the load balancer is being provisioned. Let's have a look under auto scaling groups, and there's nothing there yet, so I'll keep refreshing and see what's happening. We now have the auto scaling group being created. So if we head up to instances, we've got a desired capacity of 2, so hopefully we should see 2 instances being launched as well. And there they are, so we've got 2 running instances. If I come back to my stack, it's worth just hitting refresh every now and then. And you can see that there's still quite a lot going on. So it's not complete yet. We've got to give it a few minutes to complete. And then once it's done, we should have an output here. So we don't have anything yet, but we should have a URL as an output that we can use to connect to our application. So that didn't take much longer, and now it does all look like it's complete, and we have this URL here. So on events, we can see we have a create complete, and there's still stuff that looks like it's in progress, but sometimes it just does that for a while. But we do have our output, so we can try and connect to this, and let's see what happens. So I'm trying to connect to this URL, and as you can see, it's not getting anywhere, it's kind of hanging. Now that gives me a few clues as to what's going on here. So let's have a look at some troubleshooting. The first thing to do is to go and check your target groups. You need to find out whether your instances are actually healthy. So we go to targets, and the instances are healthy. So that's good. That means that they should be attached to the load balancer and able to receive traffic. Now, whenever I get this where it actually hangs, it doesn't fail with an error message, but it's just hanging. It usually tells me that the security group is the problem. So let's go and have a look at the configuration of the security groups for these resources. So firstly, we have our load balancer. Let's click on Actions, Edit Security Groups. And it's in the default security group. So we need to go and have a look at that security group. I'm going to head to Security Groups here, go to Default, and let's see what the rules are. So the rules for default are to allow all traffic from itself. So that means it's not going to accept traffic from the internet. So there's no wonder that's not going to work. But let's also check out the security groups for our instances. So we'll click on the instance and go to networking, change security groups. And we can see they're in this group, which is the elastic load balancer with auto scaling group. So let's have a look at that one. So that's this group on the top here. And what we can see is that the security group here is allowing traffic inbound on port 80 from this group here. And that is the group that the load balancer is in. So that's good. What that means is the load balancer is able to send traffic on port 80 to the instances. And if it couldn't do that, then the health checks would have failed. So that's why we know that this is definitely working. So I think the only problem here is that this default security group is not allowing access from the outside. So what I'm going to do is hit edit, click on add rule. I'm going to put one in for HTTP, choose 0.0.0.0/0, which as you know is any address. Click on save rules. And now let's go back and we're going to just try that again. So I'll right click this link, just open it in a new tab. And now we've got a successful result. So you've always got to watch out for security groups. Sometimes they're not configured properly. And when that happens, often you'll find that the connection hangs. So it doesn't error with a message. It just doesn't seem to complete. And that's a great clue that it might be something to do with a security group. So that's it. We've launched that stack. It was obviously quite a complex stack, but really easy to do with a template that we've been able to use. So I hope you enjoyed that. Let's go back in now, and we're going to kill off this stack to make sure you don't spend any money. So we'll go back to stacks, check this one, click on delete, and let's delete this stack. And again, make sure you watch this and make sure that all resources are successfully deleted.